Welcome back to more Roger Wilco and the Spinal Frontier. Get out of this hole. Hey, baby.
What's that? It looks like the end of a used Q-tip. Interesting. She appears to be waiting for someone. She might be one of those professional ladies your mom told you about. It's one of those Bjorn guys. It's so cute when they talk about assimilating everyone.
Hey!
Hey!
I wonder if you... Nah, what was I thinking? Hey! Hey!
What the fuck? Get off me, man!
He's too far away or doesn't care. He's too...
Interesting for me.
Hey!
He ignores you. Get used to it.
It's not very nice.
Hey! Buddy, maybe you can help me out. I'm trying to track down this endodroid. I'm an endodroid runner. I know it don't look so hot, but I'm in disguise, you know?
In disguise? Yeah, you do look disguised. I just don't know what like. Hey, here's a tip. Think seriously about a flea dip.
I could really use your help getting this one. I've had a hell of a time tracking him down. You've got to help me. Tell you what, if you can find and immobilize this bionic beer opener, it's worth 50 buckazoids to you. What do you say to that? I've scoured this dung heap. I haven't seen synthetic hide nor hair of him. All that's left to check is that bar. I'd go in there myself, you see, but I've had a little misunderstanding with the management. No biggie. I'm sure it'll blow over soon. Anyway, can you help me out? What do you say? 50 buckazoids. And if you don't mind me saying it, you look like you could use it. So how about it?
Well, I don't know. What's this endodroid thing look like? And why do you want it?
Well, he's about your height. Only maybe a few inches higher. And I'd say about your weight, give or take 60 pounds or so. But then that's just probably because of that stuff he's made of. Kind of a liquid metal thing, but that's not important. He's got a crew cut, and I think he was wearing a long, dark coat. Has a strange accent.
But why do you want him?
Oh, he made some people mad.
How?
Oh, I guess he sort of jumped out of his program and kind of killed and or mangled a score or so of co-workers, and more importantly, management personnel. A big no-no. No big deal. I just gotta take him in for analysis and processing. It could help pull me out of my, unfortunate cash flow situation. And most importantly, it can mean 50 buckazoids for you. What do you say?
Well, I could use the buckazoids. I'll see what I can do.
Great. You won't regret it. You're gonna need this data recorder. It's been modified to only be sensitive to certain unique components like droidium, something only an endodroid would be composed of. This'll help you root him out. Good luck. Let me know when you've got him. Thanks. I gotta go check in with the home office. I'll check back out here a little later to see how you're coming along.
No problem. Alright, so he said he's in the bar.
Well, that wasn't too bad for a borderline physical specimen like you. It didn't quite get the job done, though. Nah, you still haven't convinced the door to yield to your obviously superior physical presence. Wow, you really did it! Not exactly the subtlest of entry techniques, but effective. That's pretty macho for the likes of you. Who would have guessed you'd have the makings of a Starsky or a Hutch, or a Tango or a Cash?
Boss.
You go now and I don't rearrange your organs.
That rearranges my organs. You're coming with me.
There, that's a great improvement. Look much better now.
Well, he did warn you. I'm not going to say he told you so, but he did.
Yeah, that's true, he did.
It's the endodroid, and he's repairing himself. Yuck.
What is that, an alien? What are you gonna do? You gonna do it to me again?
There, that's a great improvement. Look much better now.
Well, he did warn you.
He's not fashioned over after Arnold Schwarzenegger from the Terminator or nothing. Not at all. We'll just take our metal bar and leave.
You're with Bali Sorbet Security, huh? Yeah, what can I get for you, Chief?
What have you got?
Well, aside from the obvious stuff which is glaring in your face from the back wall here, I do make some mixed drinks. If you say so myself, I make a pretty mean William Gibson and a pretty good Asimov cocktail, you know what I mean, huh? Hey, I got you. Try a fuzzy toad jam. They seem to be pretty popular with your particular, species here. I got just the thing for you guys. It's something I don't even give the regulars here. What do you think, huh?
Take the special.
Make me a double uvula spritzer. Twist a Fleck rind, and I want it hacked and whipped, not like one of those shaken or stirred sissy drinks.
Of Okay, coming right up, Chief. Listen, this'll take a couple of minutes, but feast your eyes on the making of it, all right?
Oh, that's just fine. Take your time, my good man.
An interesting arrangement of conduits creates an almost artistic pattern to the back bar area. It's hard to tell what is merely decorative and what is functional. It's solidly in place. It's solidly in place. It wouldn't be prudent.
Yo!
This one doesn't spew anything. With a flick of your very supple wrist, you pull the conduit loose from below the valve.
Oops!
Try the other conduit first. Just try the... That's an... Try it, boy. Try
the... What are you talking about, man?
As cool as it would be. The hookah hose is now attached to the leftmost conduit. You complete the connection between the two conduits.
You gotta kinda do all this semi-fast. I forgot you had to hook up the one tube first. And of course this bitch is gonna be in the way.
Nitro begins to flow.
Nitro's flying in through the tubes now. And look what jackass is frozen solid.
Frostalakista, baby.
Wow, it worked! This dude's in a deep freeze. But now, what are you going to do with him?
I'm gonna put him in a permanent deep freeze.
Cool! Laying a solid blow upside the head of this frigid felon has reduced him to cubes. Is not too hard to handle now. You quite cleverly whisk the cubed culprit into your dustpan. It's going to be tough to carry him this way, though. Very good. He'll be much more transportable this way. However, you'd better hope it doesn't thaw. It appears that the bartender disconnected your cleverly concocted hose link while you were gone.
What can I do?
What have you got?
Well, if I got...
Make me a...
Oh.
Oh.
It probably seemed like a good idea. It looks vaguely like your hiney after...
Let's look at it together and see what...
That should be frozen out.
The floor has that... The floor...
Here's your cubed compadre. Where's my 50 buckazoids?
No bull. You really got him, eh? I mean, good job.
Yeah, I really got him. And I could really use my 50 buckazoids.
Tell you what, I'll pay you when they pay me.
No, I need the money now. Or I let the guy thaw right here, right now.
No, just a minute. You don't want to do that. Hold on to your alimentary contents. I got it here. Here, you happy? I'll just be taking that tray. Been a special treat doing business with you.
Hey, I'm fulfilling my part of the bargain.
He's too far away, or...
Hey!
Fuck.
Hey. Hey. Hey.
Very odd.
Hey. Hey!
He's supposed to talk to
me. He's too far away.
Hey! Hey! Hey!
You.
Some quirky shit.
Hey! 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 Hey!
He's too... He's too far away, or... Your utterances... You start to see... He's too...
Hey! Hey!
This is fucking retarded.
Hey!
The streets of... No, can it be? It is. It's Elmo Pug, the former CEO of Scumsoft. Hard times have hit him like a ball-peen hammer between the, eyes. Maybe there is a karma fairy. Look at him. Do you really think that's a wise idea?
No, it'd be great if you'd fucking talk to him, though.
Oh yeah, that. I hope to forget that. It was the beginning of my undoing. I was a laughingstock around the company in the final days of Scumsoft. Oh well, if that hadn't gotten me, some of my other creative management techniques would have. In looking at the big picture, I suppose that arrangement left me with all my physical assets intact. Not a single other thing, unfortunately. I'm humiliated to admit that I have, on rare occasion, resorted to selling cheat sheets for arcade games. I've got to maintain a fairly, modest profile, I guess you could say. Time heals wounds and all that. Plus, maybe I can avoid a premature termination.
Wow. That's all very interesting. And very boring, if you don't mind my saying. What I want to know is, can you sell me a cheat sheet for Stooge Fighter 3?
Well, I think I may be able to facilitate that. I may have one in stock. Okay, here's what I need from you. A nice new bottle of Coldsordian brandy. If you can deliver that, I think we can call it a deal. My people, I mean, I'll be waiting to take delivery from you so that we can put a bow on this deal. Catch you later.
Alright, so I had to click on that guy like 17 million times. I have no clue why that took so long. It would just not register. Anyways, he wants a bottle of Coldsordian brandy. So where else to get that but bootlicker? E.T.
This little fleshwad looks familiar. You wonder what he's doing here. Must have been a victim of the telecommunications wars. Pa Conchohawken sits behind the counter by his favorite possession. Something he values greater than his own life, the cash register. Pa's been in business for quite a while, as his grizzled look might attest. Were it working this device, it, as noted on its top, would supply ice. A camera covers every square centimeter around the clerk just for security measures. It's amazing what kinds of crimes people will commit to get some of Pa's special stock.
Hi there.
Howdy there, partner. The name's Paul. Paul Conchohawken. Yeah, it's my name. I'm the proprietor of this here establishment here. Now, anything I can sell you, why, you just let me know. But if you steal anything, I'll be forced to kind of kill you. Welcome.
That, sounds fair. So, Pa, what's the stuff behind you?
Oh, that, eh? Why, that there's the good stuff, sonny. I got some real fine stuff back here. Oh, yeah, I do. That's Coldsordian brandy. That's what that is. Best available in these parts here. Now, it's way out of your price range, I'm sure. It goes for 20 buckazoids per.
Well, that's what we need.
I'd like a bottle of your Coldsordian brandy, please.
Well, so you're interested in the good stuff, eh? I'll just take that 20. Thank you. I haven't sold much of this stuff lately, except for some sorry-looking little pud. Oh, hey, that reminds me. He still owes me some money. Oh, I can't believe I fell for that scam. Oh, well, enjoy. Sucker.
T-Vonal.
Yes! Mr. Wilco, I'm most pleased you've chosen to do business with us. You're just in time, too. I have another party on his way interested in the same item. Oh, well, his loss. Well, I'll take that off your hands. Now, per our agreement, here's your cheat sheet. I'm certain you'll find the game much more interesting now. Also, you look like you could use this fish. Enjoy, Mr. Wilco. I have a real important business in another part of town. Be seeing you.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, by the way, I'd appreciate if you'd not mention our meeting to anyone. Some of those purple-skulled old stockholders really hold a grudge, okay?
Let's see what we got here.
It's the Stooge Fighter 3 cheat sheet you got from Elmo.
A-B-B-A.
To guarantee a win,
C-A.
The cheat sheet says,
C-A.
When at the choice screen, press the machine's letter buttons in the following order. A, B, B, A, C, A, C, A. Then, be aggressive and attack as much as possible using your new secret weapon.
Cool. I got a cheat sheet. Fish looks groovy.
It looks vaguely like your hiney after it's been chewed out by your boss.
The fish does?
It looks vaguely...
Let's look at it together and see what we can see, okay? It's your trusty whisk. This is the data.
It looks vague...
Something ain't right. Something just ain't right about Dial. Hey, Jerkwad, want to get your ass whipped?
Hi, Mr. Jerkwad. How about another game of Stooge Fighter? I'm feeling a little luckier this time.
You know, kid, I'd really like to, but I need a little more of a challenge. Take a long walk off a short asteroid, okay?
What's the matter? Afraid a measly little pencil-neck low-life janitor and general waste of human life is going to embarrass you in front of your friends?
Oh, snap.
Well said.
Hold on there, you little puke. I'm not afraid of some puny little zit on the butt of the universe.
Jerkwad is a scaredy cat. Jerkwad is a scaredy cat.
All right, you little wad of spit. Let's play. I'll waste you. Tell you what. Let's make it interesting. If you win, I'll give you 300 buckazoids. However, if I win, you're mine to do with as I see fit. The deal? Oh, this is gonna be fun! You're a bit puny, but I'm sure I'll be able to get a few buckazoids for you over at the slave colony.
I'm sorry, I don't think I heard you quite right. Did you say a slave colony?
Too late to back out, bored breath.
I knew that.
It's the secret button.
Let's get ready to rumble!
Where's my money?
Here. Now if I were you, I'd make myself scarce, you little lump of phlegm. Otherwise I'm gonna lose my temper and all that's gonna be left of you is teeth and toenails.
What a sore sport. Alright folks, that wraps it up for this episode. Stay tuned for more Space Quest 6!